to meet you, Shira. Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Good to see you.
Okay. Hey, Peter, congratulations to get a Grammy Award. You know, what are you feeling after having won three of them?
Well, we expected to win none, absolutely none. I was pleasantly surprised, and I was mostly pleased that at this Grammys they awarded Lifetime Achievement Awards to Muddy Waters and John Coltrane, who are two of my idols. Sometimes I feel that maybe R.E.M. doesn't exactly fit in with everyone that wins Grammys, but it was nice to see that the Grammys are now rewarding people who've done really wonderful work and people that I really admire. And it was interesting. It was an interesting experience.
What does a Grammy Award mean to you, as personally, or one of the members of R.E.M.?
Well, a Grammy was always something we figured that we would never win, because for years the Grammy was Grammys were very, very conservative. So they tended to vote for older, you know, adult artists, and they're now loosening up a little bit. And so in the last few years, I've been noticing that I'm listening to more and more people that do win Grammys or that are up for Grammy nominations. So, you know, I was honored to win one.
Sure.
Then again, we just make the records for ourselves. Okay? And for us, this record, the Abtime record, it's an old record now. We're already starting the next one. So we're being rewarded for something we did in the past, which is nice, but, you know, it's also way in the past for us. Record by record, we feel like we're just walking down a road, and each record is just another stepping stone. And we started with Murmur, and after every record we think, well, what did we do wrong that time? What do we want to do right this time? What do we not want to repeat? So it's kind of a conscious effort to just keep moving in one direction. I doubt we'll ever be a jazz band or a blues band.
Yes.
But there are lots of different influences we could bring into the group, a lot of different songwriting ideas that we haven't touched yet. And that's part of one of the goals that you have as a band, to keep kind of growing in that way.
Yeah, right. How do you think about it?
Well, gotta remember, first of all, none of us ever graduated from college. But in America, colleges themselves have radio stations. And, you know, like in Japan, there are some too. I've been to one anyway.
Yes.
But so they're mostly run by people who aren't professional DJs. They tend to play more what interests them, so they don't have to play top 40 music or music that is very successful.
Oh, I see.
And at the time we came along, these people, in a lot of the stations, found us in a lot of our peer group, whether it be the Dream Syndicate or Black Flag or, you know, the Neville Brothers. People that are a little out of the mainstream thought that would be interesting stuff to play. So that's why the whole college radio thing we were part of. I mean, like I said, none of us finished college.
And the next question, if you could comment just on the American music scene.
I mean, there's a lot of great stuff going on in America right now. Musically, I'm not really sure the Grammys always reflect it. Nothing against the Grammys, but the Grammys are tend to be voted on by older people. And that's fine. I mean, that's the place of the Grammys. Personally, most of the music I listen to doesn't really appear on the Grammys. You know, I know that independent labels now are kind of dying out. The smaller labels are kind of disappearing. But there's still lots of good stuff coming out. The smaller labels graduating to big labels, whether it be, you know, Nirvana, which is a huge group, or someone like Superchunk, who are a small band from South Carolina, who have just gotten signed to a major label. There's lots of stuff going on, but there isn't really, it doesn't seem like there's a real movement. There's just people making music individually in cities. You know, it might be another 8 years until there's some kind of feel like there was in 1976.